You and me, we're administrators on our computers, right? At least our lab, anyway. My daughters, they're not. If they had the power we had, they would break everything. So in this video, I want to show you how you can control the permissions of your users. So check it out. In a previous video, the one you just watched, we created a new user. I showed you how. Let's do that real quick right now, just for practice. And I'm gonna show you a way I did not show you before. And you might be like, Chuck, why didn't you show me that before? That was way easier than before. You'll see. Terminal. Let's launch a terminal as administrator. Now before I said, hey, we're gonna add a user, we'll type in the commandlet new -local user. And then we did a bunch of stuff after that. Did you know that you can just skip that and just hit enter? And it's gonna ask you for everything in a nice little prompt way. So let's do that. We'll call this user Bill. Password, password. Notice it does that secure string for us by default. It's great. And that's it. That's Bill. Now Bill right now has almost zero power. Let me show you. We're gonna launch computer management. Again, if I can spell computer right, that'd be a good day. We'll go to our local users and groups. Go to users and try to find Bill. There's Bill. Let's click on Bill. I said Bill a lot. Now here, it may not be totally obvious where you might see security or permissions for a user, but where we'll find it is member of. And that's how Windows likes to control their security. What group are you part of? Because the group itself will give you permissions. I'll show you. Let's click on member of. Right now, Bill doesn't have any groups at all. He's alone. He's got no permissions. Let's change that. Let's click on add right here. Now we'll add him to a group here in a second, but click on cancel. I want to show you the list of groups. Notice over here, just under users in our menu, we have, well, what do you know? Groups. Let's take a look. That's a lot of groups. And each of these groups has a specific purpose. It even tells you in the description, like what's going on. Let me expand that out a bit so you can see it. We're not gonna go over every one of these, but I'll highlight a few. For example, the group that most users are going to have will be the users group. And I believe when you add a user through computer management, they automatically get that. Now Bill, because we did it via command line, he didn't get anything. And this is a safe group. It tells you right here, like, hey, users are prevented from doing stuff, essentially. But you do need this profile if you want to be able to log into the system. Like, you can't log in if you're not part of the user group because you're not a user. Now, that's the lowest group. The group that has serious power, the one that we're probably part of, I'm assuming you are, I am, is the administrators group. Administrators have complete and unrestricted access to the computer/domain. We can do anything we want. So be very careful who you assign to the administrator group. Make it exclusive. And then you'll notice down the line, we have specific things. Like one thing you'll probably see a lot is remote desktop users. If you want a user to be able to log into a computer remotely, they need this permission. I had to do this all the time on the help desk. People are like, I want to work from home. I want to log into my computer. They didn't have these permissions. You have to add those permissions. Now enough about that. Let's make Bill, a user, part of the user group. So we'll go back to users. Go back to Bill. Click on member of, and here we'll click on add. Now notice Windows kind of does this thing where they're like, guess. That's what it kind of feels like. So I'm like, I know I want it to be users. I guessed it. Did I get it right? Click on check names. I got it right. It's just kind of a silly way to do it, but it's a quick way. Like we could skip that and just go to advanced and then click on find now. And we could find the groups. So users group, there it is. And we'll click okay, apply, okay. Now Bill has user permissions and he can log into the system. Now before we go, I do want to show you how to do this via command line, because why not? So let's launch terminal once more as administrator, because you know, that's who we are. And let's try the command git -local group member, kind of a mouthful. And we'll do name, and this will be the name of the group. Let's do users. This is showing us everyone part of the users group. Let's do administrators. Look at that. And what do you say we give Bill some power? Let's add him to this group. With the command add -local group member, we'll specify the group with a -group. This is administrators. And we'll specify the member -member as Bill. Done. So now if we hit the up arrow twice to get our git -local group member -name administrators, Bill's in there. If we check our computer management and look at Bill. Bill's got some power now. So that was your brief intro, brief covering of user permissions and how we do that with user groups and Windows. I'll see you, where's my coffee, in the next episode.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. For more IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.